Hello friends, welcome back to the second part of PHP with MySQL. In this session, we are going to see actual code to connect to the MySQL database using PHP. So see, I have written one file mysqlpdo.php in which I have started with the code. I have prepared some variables host, which is the local host I am running because my database is also running on the same machine. Then the database name, which I have created in MySQL, name of the database is sample. Username of that database management system is root, and I have kept the password blank. So these four variables I have created so that I can use these four variables for preparing the connection string. And then I have declared one variable connection. Then in this video, I have also shown how to use the try catch, as we can use the exception handling mechanism. In PHP also, we can use the try catch block, try, and this is the catch block. To that, we have to pass the object of the exception which may occur, so that if the body of the try, any statement has an exception that can be catched properly, proper message will be given, that exception will be handled properly, and rest of the code will run. Let's concentrate on database connectivity. As we seen, that first step is connect to the database. So here first I am preparing the connection string. As I told in the last session, connection string has a MySQL colon host equal to, we have to give the host name. Now here we have created the host with the host variable where we have assigned the local host. So that local host name will come here, comma DB name. With this attribute, we have to set the database which we want to connect. So here database we are using is a sample, that variable will be assigned. So this will prepare the connection string. For checking, you can print this connection string and check that is it going correct or not. Then after preparing the connection string, I am creating the object of PDO with connection variable equal to new PDO. To that I am passing three parameters. First is the connection string which we have created here, then username of the database root, and password blank. If your database system has some password, you can assign the password here, so that password will be used. If this statement executes correctly, then it will print that connected to the database and the which database you have mentioned successfully. This statement will execute means your database connection is successful. First step. Then second step is we can prepare the query. So see here, I have prepared the query. Select roll number and name. These are the two columns. I want to retrieve the values of these columns from table student, which is in the database sample. Sample is the database in which I have created one table student, and from that I am retrieving these two values. Then next, third step is, once query is prepared, third step is execute the query. So for that we have to prepare the statement. So for that code is statement equal to connection, which has a prepare method. To that we have to pass the query statement. The query will be prepared, and then we have to fire the query with the statement execute function. Then this will execute the query and retrieve the result. Result will be stored in the statement object. How to retrieve? For that next step is we will use one loop in which this loop will retrieve the one row at a time in row variable with the statements fetch function. To that PDO colon colon fetch associative, this we have to pass. So this statement will run once and retrieve one row. That row will be saved in this. Then it will go inside the loop, and from this row, if you want to retrieve the column values, we have to mention column name like this. I want to print on next line roll number and actual roll number. For that, this is the row variable in which the currently fetched row values are there. To that I have to pass the column name, which column value you want to retrieve from that current row in single quote dot name, and then second column name row name. Then it will go for the next, it will fetch next print. This will return true until there is a next record in the row as a result of this execution. Once all records are over, this will return false and it will come out of the loop. And then last statement is close the connection. So for that connection variable I have made null. So after that reveal that connection to the database is successfully closed. So this is the way to write the code. Let's check how to create the database and use it. As we learn early, for this we are going to use a XAMPP application. XAMPP, that is a X means don't care, it may be used for Linux or Windows platform. A means Apache, M means MySQL, P means PHP. So once you install the XAMPP, you can start this control panel. In that control panel, you can have Apache, MySQL, FileZilla, Mercury.gat, whatever options you have selected at the time of installation. From that, now we have to start to Apache. So you can click start here. I have already clicked to start it. Otherwise, if that is not started, this search button will be there. So start Apache. So it will start the server, web server. Then start the MySQL database server by clicking here. So here you can observe that on which port your web server and the MySQL database server is running. Once these are successfully running, this will show that status Apache app start, status running, and for MySQL running means your web server and a database MySQL server is running. Then minimize this window and open the browser. Then when you will type, let me show it once again. I have to open the database management system. I have to go to the PHP MyAdmin. So for that, I have to type localhost. Now this Apache server, PHP MyAdmin server is running on the port number 83. So I am writing that, and then PHP MyAdmin. So this is the URL to go to the PHP MyAdmin. Try to open this. Using this, you can manipulate the database directly. You can connect to the database MySQL server, and then you can create the database, modify the database, create new tables, fire different queries. So if I press enter, you will find that you will get this PHP MyAdmin window. So here the first option is database. If you create on this, it will show any databases are already created, and you can create new database also. If you write here, suppose test123, this is the new database I want to create, then you can write here and click create. So if you observe already there is no any test123, when I will go to create it, then it will be a new database available. So if I once again click here on the server database, so you will find that test123 is created. Like that, you can create your own database. Inside that database also you can create your table. Right now for this application we have used this database sample. So I am opening it. After going to the sample, you can create new tables. I have already created one table whose name is STUD. If I check the structure of this table, data inside this table has two columns, roll number and name, and these are the three values already inserted in the table. So this is the database we have created, sample and STUD. Fine, and that's why we have written here database name is sample, and when we are firing the query, we are writing the student table. So let's check the output of this. Let me open that file. That file is mysqlpdo.php. When I will click on this, it will retrieve the data from the database and show the contents of the database. So see, connection to the database sample is successfully. Roll number 1, name ABC, roll number 2, PQR, roll number 0 and name 3. So 3 values printed and connection closed. So if you see here in the database, there are 3 rows. Those 3 rows are retrieved and displayed. So this is the way to connect to the database. We have checked it with the code and the execution. One more code I would like to share. What type of application will be? You will have one form. From that form, you have to take the data. That form will be submitted to the server. So on server, PHP code will be there. We have seen already form handling. So with that concept, we can retrieve the data from the form and we can insert that data in the database. So let's check that application. For that, we will check the execution first, then we will check the code. So this is one more code I have written. There is one HTML file, insert sample.html, and in this I have written the code to I am asking user to enter the name and the roll number. Suppose I am writing the name, suppose PPP, and the roll number, let roll number is 4. When I will click on this, it will go to the another PHP file. That PHP file will retrieve this data and insert this name and roll number in the database, so that we will get this data inserted into the database. So when I will click on this, see, connection to the database successfully. This is the query, insert into student, the values retrieved, and here is the message, record inserted successfully, and after the database is closed. So let's check first data is inserted or not, then we will check the code for both the file. This second file where this form is submitted, that second file name is addstud.php. So let's check. If I refresh it, let's check the values are inserted in the database or not. If I go to browse that table and see this 4 and PHP, this new value is inserted into the database. So the code here is the insert.html. In that, it is a simple HTML form, HTML which is preparing a form, okay, and that form, it has one table, 3 rows. First row is, it is showing the name and the text box for name with the name attribute, then roll number, text box for name, roll number, then third, there is a submit button. So this is the HTML form, simple form, which is accepting name and roll number using text box, and there is a submit button. When you will submit this, it is going to the addstud.php file. So let's check what is the code for that. This is the addstud.php. Here it is retrieving that data. As we can see that this data is sent with the post method. So we have to retrieve that with the post object. So name is equal to post name, roll number is equal to post roll number. Once data is retrieved, then we can go with the steps. We can define what are the database contents. Host name, database name, username and password. Then connect to the database. As we have seen, connection string, PDO object, pass connection string, username and password, and once it is successful connection, it will print this message. Then the query. So see how query is built, prepared, insert into stored values. Data till this is a fixed, so I have prepared that as a string. Then I have concatenated with the roll number, which is sent by the user and which is retrieved here in the roll number variable. Similarly for name dot comma, name is a string, so single quote. So see, this is a fixed string. Then again I have to add dot name dot single quote complete and bracket complete. So these two values, so this will prepare the final query. And after that, I have displayed that query. Let's check that query. This is the query. Insert into stud_val 4. 4 came from that roll number text box with then comma, single quote, and this PPP, comma, and quote, and bracket complete. This is the second parameter. And then finally, statement is equal to connection, prepare, and query. This is the prepare. And execute is the statement to execute that query. Once this query will be executed, it will return true or false. If it is a true, then it will say record inserted successfully. Otherwise, here I have not mentioned any message, but you can give the proper message what is the reason, or you can give the record is not inserted successfully. Please try again. So, and then you can write the connection close statement, and connection is closed to the database. So this is the way, we can connect. We can use this PHP and database connectivity to fire query like select, insert, update, delete, or we can go with some DDL queries, create database, alter table, this type, or we can go for the rollback, commit, this type of transaction management.